सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 24/7। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन टुडे सेशन गाइस एज यूजुअली आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू फाइव इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज। दिस सेशन गाइस इज बेनिफिशियल फॉर वेरियस गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स एंड स्पेशली इट इज वेरी बेनिफिशियल फॉर ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर न्यू हियर, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन। And also, you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Or iska link aapko description mein mil jayega. Okay? So let's begin with the session. And the very first question is: recently, Union Education Minister, who is Dr. Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank, has inaugurated the online training and learning academy for faculty development program of AICTE, All India Council for Technical Education. So you have to name the program. Which program? What is the name of this program? Okay, so let's talk about this news. So this program of AICT is named as Atal Faculty Development Program after the former Prime Minister of India, Atal Bihari Vajpayee. So the name is what? Atal Faculty Development Program, and Atal stands for AICTE Training and Learning. Okay, what is the full form of Atal? AICTE Training and Learning is the full form of Atal, and it is for the and it is a faculty development program for the development of faculty. And under this program, AICTE will provide training to the teachers in the field of technology, because AICTE deals with those institutes which are expert in technology. So therefore, these teachers and these faculties will be provided training in the field of technology. All right. And if we talk about objective of this program, so iska jo basic objective hai, that is to provide quality technical education in our country, and also to promote research and entrepreneurship among the teachers by imparting them training in the field of technology. Okay, and the total cost for this year, matlab is saal ke liye is program mein jo total kharcha hoga, that will be how much? Rupees 10 crores. And through this program, government has a target to train around 1 lakh faculty in the field of their respective technology. Okay, so over 1 lakh faculty members ko training provide karai jayegi in the 100 emerging areas. Jo emerging areas honge उनको आइडेंटिफाई किया जाएगा, एंड इन दोज एरियाज द ट्रेनिंग विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू ओवर 1 लाख फैकल्टी मेंबर्स विद अ टोटल एस्टिमेटेड कॉस्ट फॉर दिस ईयर इज हाउ मच? रुपीज 10 करोड़। ओके, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी व्हाट? नेम द प्रोग्राम अटल अकेडमी। सो ऑप्शन ए अटल अकेडमी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर, एंड रिमेंबर इट इज नेम्ड आफ्टर ऑफ कोर्स द फॉर्मर प्राइम मिनिस्टर अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी, हुज बर्थडे 25th दिसंबर इज ऑब्जर्व्ड एज द गुड गवर्नेंस डे, Good Governance Day in our country. Okay, so let's begin with, now let's move on to question number 2. Which international organization in collaboration with Invest India, okay, so Invest India of course is an Indian organization, has launched SDG Investor Map Report. So the name of report is what? SDG Investor Map Report for India, highlighting investment opportunity areas in 6 sustainable development goals. Okay, so basically this report tells about कि हाउ इंडिया कैन मैप इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन द सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल, एंड इन दिस रिपोर्ट 6 सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स हैव बीन आइडेंटिफाइड, एंड दिस रिपोर्ट आइडेंटिफाइज दैट हाउ इंडिया कैन प्रमोट यू नो इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन दीज 6 सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स. ओके, सो दिस इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन गाइज इज यूएनडीपी. सो यूएनडीपी अलॉन्ग विद इन्वेस्ट इंडिया हैज लॉन्च दिस रिपोर्ट विच इज नेम्ड एज एसडीजी इन्वेस्टर मैप फॉर इंडिया, एंड इट इज दीज This report talks about 6 SDGs, which are health, education, agriculture and allied activities, of course, financial services, then we have sustainable environment, and finally number 6, it is renewable energy. So just remember the names of these 6 SDGs. और इस रिपोर्ट में इन 6 के बारे में बात की गई है, और ये बताया गया है कि किस तरीके से इंडिया इन 6 सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स में इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज को बूस्ट अप कर सकता है. ओके, एंड वी ऑल नो दैट देर आर 17 सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स दैट आर टू बी अचीव बाय द ईयर 2030, एंड देर आर 169 टारगेट्स. ऑलराइट, एंड इससे ज्यादा इस रिपोर्ट में आपको कुछ भी पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है, दैट्स मोर देन इनफ. जस्ट रिमेंबर दैट which organization has released this report, and this report talks about which sustainable development goals. Okay, so therefore guys, the correct answer should be what? So what is the question? Which international organization, so this international organization is what? United Nations Development Program, which is headquartered in New York and it is currently headed by Asim Steiner. Asim Steiner is the current chief of UNDP, and talking about other organizations, so UNICEF, it is Henrietta Fore. Henrietta Fore, it is also headquartered in New York. UNESCO, Audrey Azoulay is the current chief of UNESCO and it is headquartered in Paris. And United Nations, of course, we all know Antonio Guterres, headquartered in New York. UNEP, Inger Andersen, she is from Denmark. And the headquarter of UNEP is where? In Nairobi. Okay, it is in Nairobi. So now let's move on to the question number 3. In which of the following countries international version of Umang app has not been launched? Abhi recently international version Umang app ka launch kiya gaya hai. So the question is, in which of the following countries this international version has not been launched? Okay. So the news is that, guys, the international version of Umang app has been launched, and Umang stands for Unified Mobile Application for New Age Governance. Okay. Unified Mobile Application for New Age Governance is the full form of Umang app, and recently its international version has been launched by the Minister of Electronics and IT, who is Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. He is from his Lok Sabha constituency is Patna Sahib. Okay, and this will help Indian international students, NRIs, and Indian tourists to avail the services offered by the government of India in their respective countries. So, jahan pe bhi hai, un e-governance services ka fayda utha payenge that are provided by the government of India. Okay. And talking more about Umang app, so it was launched in the year 2017 by the Ministry of Electronics and IT, which is currently headed by Ravi Shankar Prasad, and he is also the law minister of our country. And it was developed by, guys, Ministry of Electronics and IT, and of course the National E-Governance Division. Okay, it was developed by Ministry of Electronics and IT and National E-Governance Division, and through this all the e-governance services provided by the government of India are available to all the citizens through this app, Umang. Okay. And these are the countries where this international version has been launched. So you have to identify the countries with the help of their flag. So let us see how many of you can identify these countries with the help of their flag. So just take a screenshot of this and comment the name of these countries in the comment section. So let me give you a hint. I'll tell you the elected heads of all these nations. So first of all, Joe Biden, that's very easy to identify. Then we have Boris Johnson, that's also very easy to identify. Then we have Justin Trudeau. Then we have Jacinda Ardern, this is also very easy to identify. Then we have Scott Morrison. Then we have Khalifa bin Zayed. Okay, then we have Mark Rutte, and then finally Halima Yaqub. And remember, this flag is like this. Okay, it is not visible properly. One second. This flag is like this. Okay, and the elected head of the country jiska ye flag hai, Halima Yaqub. Okay, so now I hope you all can identify the nations jinke flags hain. Okay, so now let's come back to the question, and you have to comment in the comment section, guys, ki aapne kaun kaun se countries ko identify kiya. So there, yahan pe jo correct answer hoga, let me tell you the correct answer. Option E, Sri Lanka is the correct answer, because in those maps, in those flags, Sri Lanka ka flag nahi tha. Okay, so now let's move on to the question number 4. So there is one more program of NCDC that has been launched by Narendra Singh Tomar, and this program is to impart training to primary cooperative societies in rural areas of the country. Jo hamare desh ke rural areas hain, wahan pe primary cooperative societies ko training provide karane ke liye this program has been launched by Narendra Singh Tomar, who is the minister of food processing industry, agriculture and farmers welfare. Okay, and also the panchayati raj and rural development. So this program is known as Sahakar Pragya program. Okay, Sahakar Pragya program is the name of the program, and as I told you, it has been launched to promote training to provide training to primary cooperative societies in the rural areas, and there will be 45 training modules. And remember one very important thing, that this training will be provided through one of the subsidies of NCDC, and which is that is Lakshman Rao Inamdar National Cooperative Research and Development Academy. In short, it is LINAC. Okay, Remember the name of this subsidy of NCDC. NCDC, we all know, National Cooperative Development Corporation. Lakshman Rao Inamdar National Cooperative Research and Development Academy. Through this academy, this initiative will be implemented. Okay, through this academy, this training will be provided to the primary cooperative societies in the rural areas. All right. So therefore, here the correct answer is what? Option A, Sahakar Pragya. And all of these initiatives are of the NCDC, जो कि in the recent times launch किए गए हैं by NCDC. Okay. And now let's move on to the last question. Question number 5. Consider the following statements regarding Global Renewable Energy Investment Meeting and Expo, which in short also known as Reinvest. So this is the third edition of Reinvest Expo. And you have to identify the correct statement regarding this. Okay, so the Reinvest 2020, the third edition, will be inaugurated by the Prime Minister Modi later in the month of December. And the first two editions were held in the year 2015 and 2018. Jo pehla edition tha, that was in the year 2015, while the second edition was in the year 2018. Okay, so I hope you will remember this. And this expo, guys, aims to enhance the efforts to scale up the development in the renewable energy sector and the more and more deployment of renewable energy. Okay. And talking more about this event, so it will be organized by the Ministry of Electronics and IT. And what will be the theme this year? So you have to remember the theme. That's very important. Innovations for sustainable energy transitions. Okay. What will be the theme? Innovations for sustainable energy transitions. And it will be attended by manufacturers, developers, investors and innovators to discuss the efforts that can be made in the field of renewable energy. All right. So this is about Reinvest. Now let's come back to the question. So we have to identify the correct statements. So the 2020 event will be organized by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And this ministry is headed by Mr. R.K. Sinha. We all know it is headed, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Ara in Bihar. The theme for this year's edition will be Innovations for Sustainable Energy Transitions. Yes, this is the absolutely correct theme. And the first edition of Expo was held in 2014. Nahi, har cheez 2014 mein nahi hui hai, guys. 2014 mein haan, mante hain ki Modi ji ki sarkar aayi thi, but har cheez 2014 mein ho, ye baat sahi nahi hai. The first edition was held in the year 2015. Okay, so this statement is incorrect, which means only 1 and 2 will be the correct answer, option C. Alright. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the news are clear. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Aur acche se padhte raho, exam aane wale hain. All the very best. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.